Welcome to dbForge Studio for Oracle Tutorials. The tool offers a quick and convenient way to import and export data, as well as schedule and automate these operations. First, let's consider importing data from an XLS file. Right-click the database in Database Explorer and select Tools, Import Data on the shortcut menu. Then select a file to import and specify the file format. On the destination page, choose a target table. You can either import data to the existing table or create a new table for the imported data. On the options page, select the range of cells for import. dbForge Studio for Oracle allows transposing data from rows to columns while importing. Just click to select Data in Rows or Columns. On this tab, you can also configure headers for the imported data columns. For example, you can select to use the first row in a range as a header, specify a row to be used as a header, or select not to use headers at all. On the Data Formats page, you can configure a data format for all columns or set a format for each column separately. On the Mapping page, you can modify the target table structure, add new columns, change the existing ones, etc. Let's change the columns. The wizard allows using different modes when processing data: appending, modifying, or updating. Click Use a single transaction if you might need to roll back the data import afterwards, since it is better to perform it within one transaction in this case. On the next page, you can set error processing rules. Let's import data again. Select to add new data to the existing table. Enter its name in the filter field and select the first table in the list. The range of data for import can be selected automatically or manually. As you can see, there are no changes on the mapping page. Select the import mode Append Update, enable the Use a Single Transaction option, and start importing. Now let's take a look at the result. dbForge Studio for Oracle allows exporting data directly from the data editor. For this, click Export SQL. Alternatively, you may select the option from the shortcut menu. The settings can be saved. You can also download templates that can be used to work with the command line. On the source page, you can select tables or views to be exported to separate files or to a single file. On the Options page, select a SQL statement type to be created: insert, update, delete, or merge. On the Table Columns page, you can exclude specific columns from export, set keys, and change the column names. On the Exported Rows page, you can set a range of rows to be exported: all rows, the selected rows, or a specific range of rows. And here is the result. Now let's consider the export of the selected columns. We have filtered data and selected rows to export. As you can see, the file name matches the table name. Select the merge statement type. And then select Export Selected Rows Only. Let's take a look at the result. To automate the data import and export tasks, you can use the command line. To view the startup commands, type the following in the command line, and the list of import commands to be used for setup will be displayed on the screen. To view the export commands, run the following. As mentioned earlier, to simplify the customization of data export and import operations, you can make the necessary configurations visually in the command line wizard and immediately receive a command with arguments to run from the command line. Furthermore, in the command line wizard, you can check the settings and save the generated command to a bat file. For example, let's create a bat file to export data from the payment table to a CSV file. right-click the table and select Export Data from the shortcut menu. As a field separator, enter a semicolon. Then go to the command line wizard and check the result. As you can see, we've got an error. There is no template. Let's create and save it. In the command line wizard, you can see a path to the template in the template file field. Now the command line is valid. When running it in the terminal, we receive an error. Access denied. Go back to the command line wizard and in the password field, set a password to access the database. Click validate to make sure that the command line is correct. Now execute it in the terminal. We see the export has been completed successfully. The generated commands can be executed both in a command line terminal and in PowerShell. Just select the corresponding checkbox and the command will be generated for PowerShell. Save the generated command to a bat file and then run this file. You can also schedule a data import or export task in the task scheduler. Just add the path to the batch file when configuring the scheduled task. For complex batch files, dbForge Studio provides a useful option to return exit codes to indicate whether a command has been successfully executed or not. It allows you to create a specific sequence of steps in the batch file and immediately understand their execution status. To output exit codes, add the echo return code at echo error level to the file or command. Just download a 30-day free trial version of dbForge Studio for Oracle and find out how easy and painless data import and export can be.